Hey guys, welcome to the video. This is part one of the USS Oliver Hazard Perry build by Academy in 1/350 scale. I didn't originally want to break this up into as many two parts as I had to, but it's just for whatever reason my computer could not handle it. So anyways, you see right here we are cutting off the hull. For the Pontos kit specifically, I'm not sure this is for both of them, but I know for the one I have, this is for a long haul Oliver Hazard Perry class. So that's like the Halliburton, which I'm doing. I believe the McKinley is also, but like the later classes to allow for Seahawks. So the fit right here was not particularly good. It wasn't bad, it's just a little warping. I think this kit's a few years old at this point, so it's to be expected to have a little bit of, problems, fit issues, but for the most part, it went together pretty well. Nothing, like, totally, detrimental to the model. It went together pretty well. I recommend putting in both the flight deck and the main deck when the glue has not set yet on the hull, just for structure. Rigidity with the structure, and also because you do not want the hull to kind of force itself to TP off, I guess is the way to put it, or like just make a triangle. You don't want those two halves to come in too far apart and then you have to pull apart the hull. As you can see here, that was not a great fit on there. Even when I took off this back part of the ship, it still wasn't a great fit. It felt kind of like an afterthought. And here, this is like the first Pontos upgrade you'll see. And so I tried to get a little experimental here with the editing. Tell me if you like it. I think it's a little different. I think it adds a little bit of flair to it. So right here, we are spray painting the tin canning, basically. I originally tried to go with black, see if it worked, but I don't think it captures it very well. I also tried doing it freehanded, which definitely didn't work, as you'll see that later on. But I think the problem with the black is that it's supposed to represent the tin canning. The way it works is it's the two pieces of steel, and then the steel put on top of it dips because there's nothing as the waves hit it. And so the ribs that are holding it up would not be darker, they'd be lighter, just based on the lighting, and the piece of steel that has concaved, would be darker. Hopefully that makes some sense. And right here you can see the whip antennas going in, and this was one of the main reasons I kind of wanted to get this kit, was because of all the antennas that come in as brass. Plastic ones over time seem to get brittler, and I have a cat that likes to walk over all my models for some reason, and so they snap off. But the brass ones, if they do snap, they're not going to snap in the middle, which is better. They're not going to snap in the middle. will snap at the bottom, which is better. And right here, we are cutting out the main structure to the mast. In all honesty, I would just go with the kit mast. It's perfectly fine. I also had a little bit of problem aligning the mast. I don't quite know what happened, but for whatever reason, I did. Apparently, it's not too uncommon. A few people I've seen talk about it, I've seen a few people talk about it. So, and this is what I have to say. This is where Pontos is kind of nice. I'm not sure if this is with it with all their other kits, but as you can see, this lattice type thing we're putting onto the part of the main mast. It is a two-dimensional piece. That's just one of them. Instead of putting on their side, if you can picture it, in just building a lattice like KA did for the Kitty Hawk, that was a pain in the butt, the KA one, but this one's nice. That's just, you put it on the bottom like that, and it simulates some structure. And now right here, you'll see me kind of struggle to put these guys on. Not a fault, I would say, but just like a little bit of a problem in the Pontos instructions. It could just be too, because I haven't used Pontos before. Some of it just didn't quite make sense until you put them on. So like originally, I had the other piece that's sticking out in towards the mast facing the other way. Alright guys, and I want to thank you so much for watching. I know your time is precious, so thank you for taking your time to watch this video. Hopefully I'll have part 2 out soon. I think I'll end up uploading both parts together at some point as one, but my computer could barely get through this video. So anyway, without taking any time left. Oh,